Since many of you, as well as supporters, wanted to see an IGL video, there is nothing stopping me to make one. Subtitles are available. I have linked in the description two more video sources, but CSGO, regarding IGLing and tips and tricks about IGLing. So, what is in-game leader or IGL? Well, the definition is not fixed, but he's the brain of your team. Someone who is calling what to do, or a strat caller in short. Don't get IGL confused with the coach. IGL is an in-game role. IGL is the person that adapts the strats, executions, ROM hunting, or anything else on a fly. Coach is first and foremost not an in-game role. IGL is the voice of your team. If you ever worked in a group or a team in real life, you will know that there is always someone that is leading it, and that would be our IGL. What IGL needs to have when you enter in a match on a map? You most likely have basic or more advanced strat what everyone should do. But the key for the success is in this or any other game is to adapt to what your enemy brings on the table. Your quote-to-quote strats will be countered for sure if you're playing in the higher tier games. Therefore, without adaptation, you'll be heavily dependent on your aim in case you want to brute force your starting strat. Even if you're a frag-heavy team, having an advantage is usually recommended. Therefore, you have to play dynamically, and there comes the IGL role. Your IGL has to have a very high game knowledge and game sense to understand the situation, even with as little information as possible. That's the most important thing what IGL needs to have, the ability to think on their feet and call dynamically. IGL's role is very hard, as you have to be great at multitasking. So, which operators are recommended for the IGLs? Average. It's usually a support type operator, but you can be an IGL as a fragger. When you die, all that you have to do is do calls and look for the intel, like flank drones or cameras. That will help you to make even better calls than being alive. But don't take this as a motivation to get killed, lol. As a support, you'll be at a similar job, holding flanks, watching drones, droning, etc., gathering information for yourself and then calling. And don't get me wrong, everybody in your team has to call to gather the information so IGL can make as precise calls as possible. Communication is the key for the success, and communication is a very complex topic on its own. Maybe if I hit enough of like buttons on this video, I'll make a such a video. But IGL is the one who speaks from the very beginning of the round to the end of the round, as well as the match. If you have ended up, for instance, 3-on-3 on Villa while defending and now you're attacking, brush up your team, keep telling your team what are the plans for the next round. You have to make them believe you can come back from this disadvantage, and when you keep the flow, there is less likely that you or your team will think about what happened in the previous round, and how Ashe not having a hitbox killed them. If one of your teammates gets triggered, do not interrupt him. Once he is done, just continue with the strat calling, shout calling, or whatever you do. Think about past rounds only when you want to play the same objective or the same route and find out what went wrong and fix it on the fly. Once the round is over, make sure that if someone did something fantastic or even just a good play, to let him know that they are insane. Being positive is usually a better approach than being negative. And when I say negative, I mean negative. By negative, I do not mean not to call actually something out that should not be done, such as overpeaking, miscommunication, too passive, wrong utility investment, and whatnot. That should be called once the round is over, and especially when the map is over, if there is a break between the maps. This is a very important aspect. You need to make your teammate understand what went wrong and how to fix that issue. Before you get a wrong impression what IGL is, IGL is not babysitting other 4 people. For instance, if you go to bank whilst you are attacking, assuming that you are the IGL, and you have planned to attack top floor from the lobby, spiral, with a rappel on the CO windows, but they are holding heavily that side with 3 or 4 people, you should say, "We will push CO, plant behind the sofa, and ex-teammate stay by the rappel at the CO windows." At this moment, everybody knows what to do. The repel player keeps the three or four people on the other side. Your team knows that they have to open the CO windows as well as clear out janitor before the push, even if your IGL did not call that. Another example will be, if you're playing on Villa and attacking Aviator in games, an IGL calls, we will do an Aviator push. In already established team, everyone knows what everyone has to be. Who has to roam clear, who has to be by the astronomy or trophy window, and later on nighty window. In newer teams, IGL will most likely be, we will clear out roamers, I need X and Y player clearing roamers, I will be droning, E player will be by the astronomy windows and drone and blah 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 blah. Well, that's not point of the IGL. IGL gives solutions, plans against a given situation. It's up to others to decide how will they approach. This one is extremely important for defense. You as a part of the strat know what you should be doing. It is up to you to decide the risk you will put yourself while doing a play. Do you have to jump out from the cafe's wide stairs window in order to keep attackers off the cocktail window? The only information you will get at this point is that someone is repelling by the cocktail window, and possibly if there are claymores or more than just one attacker there. That's up to you to decide if the play is worth or not, and your team to decide when watching VODs later on if that was a good play or not. Keep in mind that this rule is not a 10 out of 10 rule. There are situations that defenders have different kind of roaming setup, simply a pocket strat, or something that you didn't expect. Therefore, an IGL needs to call out how to push roamers, how to pinch them, and so on. So, this case is not a black-white case. Also, in some teams, there are more than just one voice in the team, because in these situations, you just need more of them. Or you have two separated roles, the one that calls during the preparation phase what to do, and one that does the micro and macro changes during the action phase, depending on the situation. But we are getting too much into the subcategory of the IGL roles, and that's not point of this video. With this, let's sum IGL role in short notes. IGL is an in-game role, different from coach, that is the voice of your team, the voice that everyone has to listen. He needs to be great at multitasking as well as understanding the game on the fly. He has to be very flexible on his approach. They have no fixed operators, however, they are usually put on a flank watcher and support kind of operators. IGL has to do micro and macro management during the round, has to keep up his team to play the round till the end of the round and make sure that there is no tilt in between the rounds. Between the rounds, IGL gathers information from his players to understand and to recap what the enemy team was doing, so they can adjust their strats accordingly. Example, from which side are you going to approach? Are you going to hunt roamers or going to a rush push? Operator selection, how to execute a push, where to plant, deep versus close, odd versus default plant spot. IGL has to call out mistakes if they are done, but after the round, and IGLs are not supposed to babysit people. However, they do call important stuff such as how to roam clear and similar stuff. If you would like to see a video about coaching role or how to communicate properly, make sure to comment down below. Thank you for watching the video. If you have any feedback, let me know down in the comment section below. If you would like to support me, drop me a like, subscribe and click notification bell not to miss any video from my channel. Make sure to join my Discord server and follow me on Twitter.